But what am I to do?
Leave it to me, said Princess Mary. I know. Pierre was looking into Princess Mary's eyes.
Well, well? He said.
I know that she loves...
will love you,
Princess Mary corrected herself. Before her words were out, Pierre had sprung up and with a frightened expression seized Princess Mary's hand.
What makes you think so? You think I may hope? You think...
Yes, I think so, said Princess Mary with a smile. Write to her parents and leave it to me. I will tell her when I can. I wish it to happen, and my heart tells me it will.
No, it cannot be. How happy I am!
But it can't be.
How happy I am! No, it can't be!
Pierre kept saying as he kissed Princess Mary's hands.
Go to Petersburg. That will be best.
And I will write to you, she said.
To Petersburg? Go there? Very well, I'll go. But I may come again tomorrow?
Next day Pierre came to say goodbye. Natasha was less animated than she had been the day before, but that day, as he looked at her, Pierre sometimes felt as if he was vanishing and that neither he nor she existed any longer, that nothing existed but happiness.
Is it possible? No, it can't be,
he told himself at every look, gesture, and word that filled his soul with joy. When, on saying goodbye, he took her thin, slender hand, he could not help holding it a little longer in his own.
Is it possible that this hand, that face, those eyes, all this treasure of feminine charm so strange to me now, is it possible that it will one day be mine forever, as familiar to me as I am to myself? No, that's impossible.
Goodbye, Count, she said aloud.
I shall look forward very much to your return, she added in a whisper.
And these simple words, her look, and the expression on her face which accompanied them, formed for 2 months the subject of inexhaustible memories, interpretations, and happy meditations for Pierre.
I shall look forward very much to your return. Yes, yes, how did she say it? Yes, I shall look forward very much to your return. Oh, how happy I am! What is happening to me? How happy I am!
Said Pierre to himself. Chapter 19. There was nothing in Pierre's soul now at all like what had troubled it during his courtship of Elaine. He did not repeat to himself with a sickening feeling of shame the words he had spoken, or say, "Oh, why did I not say that?" and "Whatever made me say je vous aime?" On the contrary, he now repeated in imagination every word that he or Natasha had spoken, and pictured every detail of her face and smile, and did not wish to diminish or add anything, but only to repeat it again and again.